Hey there, people have been asking on the YouTubes, how do I turn my MIDI click track into an audio track? And why would you want to do that for a start? Well, one of my pet hates is receiving work from other people, and by work I mean audio files from other people who've recorded in other doors and they've sent it to me and they haven't given me a tempo and they also haven't given me a click track. Two of the things that you really need to sync all of these files up inside of your door. So I'm going to flip it around. Today I've got this music idea, which is basically a whirly riff, which I think is going to be a verse, and I've come up with an idea for a chorus, and I've just recorded a rough vocal, and I've used the generate harmony feature inside of Cubase to generate a whole lot of different harmonies. So it's all very scratch, but that's the whole idea. Now I want to send it to a bass player, and I also want to send it to a collaborator to write the verse for me. So I've got everything sitting pretty much where I need it to sit, but what I really need to do is ensure that I give them the correct tempo, and also I want to make sure I give them the click track. My first tip is, if you've been recording in Cubase for years, then you're going to be used to the Cubase click track, but other people may not be. So the first thing to do is to make sure you find a sound that might be pleasing to everyone. Not that I'm saying that the traditional Cubase click track isn't, but it's just now we've got options. So we can actually go into the setup here and we can go down and we can preview different sounds over the top of the track. So I'd suggest doing that for a start. I'm going to go back with the clave. So once I've done that, I can also set the level, but I can do that once I've exported it or rendered it to an audio track as well. So not that important for actually exporting an audio click track. So I'm hitting OK. Next up, I'm going to set my left and right locator to cover everything in the project. So I'm selecting everything by drawing a box or hitting Command A. And then if I hit P on my computer keypad, that's a shortcut to set the left and right locators. And I'm giving myself a 1 bar lead-in, which is fairly standard, 1 or 2 bars. Now I'm going to this plus button and I'm going to find the time signature or the signature track. And when I hit add track, I can see it sitting there and I'm just going to drag it up here. I like to keep all of these type of tracks, utility sort of tracks up the top. Doesn't really matter that I give it a color, but I am. And now you can see that we're in 4/4. If you're in a different time signature, you could change that. I've now got the option of changing the pattern of the metronome in 4/4 or the accents of the pattern. And now to export it, we just click on this drop-down menu and you can see there's a number of different options in terms of copying and pasting and rendering the MIDI click between locators. But we've set our locator, so we're going to render the audio click between the left and right locator. And as soon as we do that, it's instantly rendered or bounced that click track or our click track for the project into audio, and it's given it its own audio track. Very quick and very easy to do. And now I can export my entire stems and all of these channels individually with my click track and send it over to people that I want to musically collaborate with. To do that, we go up to the File menu, Export and Audio Mixdown, and now we get the Export Audio Mixdown window. Now, there's plenty of videos on how to manage this and use this online, but to give you a very brief overview in this video, I'm using the multiple export option, which means that I can export multiple channels at once and I can just select the ones that I need. And of course, down the bottom there, I've selected my audio click. Now, once I've done this and I'm happy that I've ticked all the boxes that I need, I can tick a reverb if I want, I can now go over and name it. And you can see that I'm putting the BPM in there and I'm just going to give it an appropriate name. So Heart Attack BPM 81. And I've got the version number. The only other thing you might want to look at is the naming scheme. So figuring out whether you want the actual project name or the track name to go first or second, and whether you want other things or attributes to be added in there. Now it's a matter of just exporting the audio and Cubase will export all of your selected stems and your click track. Hey, thanks for taking the time to stop by and check out this video. Please subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel and give us the thumbs up. I'll catch you soon.